Get ready to match the stars. Greg Morris. Brett Summers. Gary Berghoff. Joyce Buell-Fox. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Flagg. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 75. And now here's the star of Match Game 75, Gene Rayburn.
Hello there, thank you, Johnny Olson.
I love a parade. I mean,
there was a little guy looking for you, did you see him?
Yes, I saw him.
The ding-a-lings are getting a little dingier, aren't they?
I just had to try
it. You want to walk down? Well, good, dude, try it. Do it now.
No, no, I can't
have
do
a
it
finish.
Anymore.
Oh, all right.
Okay. I didn't get to hold up my card.
You didn't? All right, hold it up now.
Oh, it says, I hate sax.
You can't say that. It's a friend of yours. You shouldn't say that about him.
They are pretty close.
What are you? Oh, you've got. Is that Alfred Newman?
No, this is a picture of my oldest son.
That's Howdy Doody.
Charlie McCarthy.
Is that Charlie McCarthy?
No, Howdy Doody.
Howdy Doody.
You're younger.
Yes.
You're younger than I thought you were.
How soon they forget.
Now watch. Inhale deeply, and you will see him frown.
Let's get on with it. Hello, Marcia Kaufman and Judy Adams. Ladies, how are you? Marcia's our current champion here with $5,600. How about that? Good. And Judy is challenging her. We've played round one, and we have a score of 0-0.
Well, that's very good.
It's what you call a pitcher's duel. And we'll see if we'll break this tieless score here in a moment or so, but first we've got this message. Here we go. Round two coming up. Judy, would you make a selection?
B.
Now, let's see. Everybody plays. Betty said, I think my husband has been a policeman too long. Last night, while he was sound asleep, he read me my rights, then he blanked me. Last night, while he was sound asleep, he read me my rights, then he blanked me.
No. You can't see that.
All right, this lower tier is ready, and Gary is ready.
Well, so is this upper tier.
All right. Now we're all set. We'll come over here to Judy Adams. This lady, Betty, said, I think my husband has been a policeman too long. Last night, while he was sound asleep, he read me my rights, then he blanked me.
Handcuffed me.
Handcuffed me. Well, that's what they do in those movies, don't they? They read you your rights, and then they handcuff you and take you away and book you and do something like that. What'd you say, Greg? You've been involved at this, haven't you?
Yes, I didn't know.
What do they do?
I didn't know where they got... What do you mean? Hey, baby, we don't all go to jail.
I mean, you've played parts like that, haven't you?
You don't. Yeah.
But you do sleep.
I said he slapped her.
He slapped her.
Now, did it again.
Yes.
Well, I saw it. Didn't match.
Ira, did you see it?
Yes, he saw it.
So
okay.
Shut up.
Said slap.
Sorry, it didn't match anyway.
Not all brutal.
Yes.
Violence on television doesn't go great.
What do you say?
I say I feel sorry for that man's wife. His?
Yes.
Well, there's only one answer, I said to him. There's only one answer. He said, oh, really? I said slap. And I said arrested.
Arrested.
I thought that would be...
Read me my rights, then he arrested me. Okay, Gary.
For the
well,
six or seven.
You say terrific or something,
no,
honey?
Rotten.
For the six.
Terrifically rotten. For the sake of.
Forget it. I said arrested too.
You said arrested too.
Can't get
well, the answer she's looking for. Last night, while my husband was sound asleep, he read me my rights and then he blanked me. Now, she says handcuffed.
And I says shot her. Oh.
That violent.
That's police brutality if I've ever heard it.
And it's hard to talk. talk to him about it afterwards.
It sure is.
But it was all right because she was only half checked.
Okay, Dawson, you're on.
I want to hear the question again.
All right. I just read it to her.
Read it to me. Hamburger.
You got a short memory, haven't you?
I never claimed to have a long one. Now read the question.
All right, here it is.
I'm sick of these bums.
Last night, while he was sound asleep,
yes,
he read me my rights, then he blanked me.
Well, I knew the woman. She was very well endowed. He read her the rights, and then he busted her.
Are you strong as I feel?
Seriously, folks.
I would have done the same thing if I were in his shoes or wherever he was. All right, speaking of bust, Fanny, what did you say?
I said arrested.
Arrested, well, okay. No handcuffs, I'm sorry to say. Now, all you need is one to win another game. And let's see if it happens. Here it is. One counterfeiter said to the other, I'm telling you this dollar bill you've made is no good. Who ever heard of George Washington with a blank?
Huh?
You're really thrilled with this question, I can see.
Oh, I know that.
Two counterfeiters are talking to one another, and one says to the other, I'm telling you this dollar bill you made is no good. Who ever heard of George Washington with a blank?
I give up. I never heard. Who did hear?
I don't know.
We've all finished that. They just
do it this way.
Stop with your gag, Nancy. I think I'm going crazy.
That's not how this story goes.
Come on, now write it, Nancy.
George please. Washington.
Who ever heard of George Washington with a blank?
I have no idea what to say.
Well, put something down. Come on. Okay. Please, Brett.
Trying.
This is the only show I've got. Please.
I know the television audience is getting free, but I'd pay to be on there.
Sorry, the service
we ordered
kind of
20 minutes ago.
I got it. Okay. My head was totally blank.
All right, Marcia. One counterfeiter said to the other, I'm telling you this dollar bill you made is no good. Who ever heard of George Washington with a...
I haven't the slightest idea. A hat?
You'd have the slightest say you drew a blank on it, huh? You've been thinking about it all this time?
Yes.
And all you can think of is hat.
It's a toughie.
All right. Well, now, on the dollar bill, he is not wearing a hat, is he? On the regular dollar bill.
I think
bill.
It's just a plain crinoline with pearls.
That would be a dumb thing.
He's wearing his normal
string of pearls.
His...
I think it's just plain black crinoline.
No. Because, you see, the white ruffle shirt, the pearls wouldn't show.
No, you're right.
But he's wearing...
Yes. Go ahead.
This is the same thing, and I want you to know that.
All right, now, wait a minute.
I said hat with a yarmulke.
A yarmulke.
That's a hat, and that wins the game.
We got some dingbat answers there. We had hernia from him.
Joyce
and you
with
had
a bird.
Bird and hat. And what did you say finally?
Without a wig.
Without a wig.
Without a wig, the world.
Well, congratulations to you. You know, you stand by for a moment or so. We've got to say goodbye to Judy Adams. Judy, it was a pleasure meeting you.
Thank you. It was great being here.
Thank you very much. We've got a gift for Judy Adams. Goodbye.
Thank you.
Message for you here, and then you come right back. Here we are with Marcia Kaufman again. She's got $5,700, and she's going to have another go at it. Ready?
Ready.
We pulled a recent studio audience. We got their best response to this. Betsy Blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, and the third, $100. Whom do you choose?
Joyce again.
Joyce again.
Betsy Ross.
All right, we got one.
Richard.
Betsy.
Betsy Palmer.
Betsy
nice
Palmer.
Like
yep.
That.
Okay.
Not Gary. As much applause as Betsy Ross.
Gary, have you got one, Gary?
All I can think of is Betsy Blaine.
Betsy Blaine?
Not many people. That's a girl I used to go out with in high school.
Come on. No, Jesus. Are you serious? That's a girl you used to go out with in high school,
yes.
Betsy Blaine?
Yeah, she's related to the Hoovers.
Yeah.
I'd take that.
Come
Come on, now, you've got to give us a better answer than that.
Betsy Blair.
Betsy Blair. Okay, you got Betsy Blair, Betsy Ross, and Betsy Palmer.
But Betsy Blaine was a better
Betsy
girl.
Ross.
You want Betsy Ross. Okay, Betsy Ross is the one she's looking for. Let's find out if it's up there, and if it's there, where is it? First, we'll find out if it's under the $100 response. No, it is not, Betsy Ross.
Well, that's Betsy Blaine's marionette.
No, sorry, that is Betsy Blaine.
That's his name.
That's why I stopped.
Marcia tells me that Betsy Wetsy is a doll.
Right.
And does you don't she hear really, us talking.
She does, huh? Oh, she does. Oh, I see. Okay.
So little girl's getting trained
here
to
we
be
go,
mothers.
Looking for Betsy
There's
Ross all over
Boopie.
The place. Let's find out if it's under the $250 response. Betsy Palmer there. That's the one that Richard gave. Yes, sir.
How quickly you forget.
Yes. Worth $250.
I'm worth it.
Now, last chance for Betsy Ross. Here is the $500 response. You got Betsy Ross. Congratulations. Well done. Now. Well, you're going to have another go at the $5,000. You're up to $6,200 now. Which celebrity would you like to try to match head-to-head?
I think I'll stick with Joyce.
Yeah. Going to stick with you, Joyce? Boy, you're getting a real workout on these shows this week, aren't you? Okay.
Yes.
Marcia, would you please face me? Here's the $5,000 question. Panty blank. That's P-A-N-T-Y blank. All right, would you ding your dinger when she... That's it, all right. She's finished. And now, Marcia, we ask you to come up with an answer which you think will match hers. Panty blank.
Hose.
You say pantyhose. Okay. Pantyhose is what she says will match you for $5,000. May we see yours, please?
I make it.
You're... Okay. All right, for $10,000, would you do that? Now may we see the answer, if you please. Joyce, are you with us?
Oh, yes, what I'm sorry.
She says pantyhose.
Pantyhose, let me see. I can't remember. It's been so long, I said hose.
Pantyhose. You think of some... She says she's going to figure out some way of spending it. She will find a way. Where is your husband sitting now? He's down the fourth row down there?
No, my grandmother's here.
Your grandmother? You turned your husband in for your grandmother?
He's babysitting the kids.
Oh, he's babysitting the kids. Which one is your grandmother now? Oh, there she is. Oh, hello there, Mrs. What's her name? Mrs. Herman. Nice to have you with us. Okay. Now, Marcia's going to play another game, so let's bring on another player right now. And welcome William Mitchell.
Hi.
Marcia. Now, William Mitchell, we'd like to hear a little bit about you, if you would please, sir.
I am from Evanston, Illinois. I'm a sports writer for a suburban newspaper in Chicago. I have a wife and two children, and they call me Billy Mitchell.
Billy Mitchell.
Not related to the Air Force, Billy Mitchell.
Shall we call you Billy?
You may.
All right, Billy, I'll push this button and ask you to make a selection.
Thank you. I'll try A, please.
A. New game, folks. Here we go. I guess everybody here... on the stage and off the stage knows how wonderful Greg Morris was on Mission Impossible.
Yeah, how wonderful was he?
I'll tell you how wonderful he was.
Greg Morris said, "My honeymoon was really an impossible mission. As soon as we got into the hotel room, my blank began to self-destruct."
She said not to mention it.
Yes. Thanks a lot, Joyce. Remember, William Mitchell is going to be trying to match you, dingbats. All right.
I just love Hollywood.
Who gave you them diamonds, you racy woman?
Now, just concentrate for a second.
I promised my mother.
All right. My honeymoon was really an impossible mission. As soon as we got into the hotel room, my blank began to self-destruct. Put something down in the car.
Joyce, dear.
Joyce,
we're waiting for you, sweetheart.
I don't
know. All right.
Okay.
We know you've been under a
surprise. All right.
She's right here.
Now, Billy Mitchell. You've seen Mission Impossible.
Yes, indeed.
And you've seen Greg Morris in it.
Yes, indeed.
Okay.
Who'd you like best?
He says, my honeymoon was really an impossible mission. As soon as we got into the hotel room, my blank began to self-destruct.
I'll say body.
My body began to... He said, my body began to self-destruct. No, he's got it all together. All right, Greg, what did you say about this?
Her body. My wife...
My wife began to self-destruct. Okay. Brett, what'd you say?
I say when you're newly married, you don't refer to your loved one as a wife. You refer to her as a bride.
A bride.
Oh.
Bride and body do not match. And Gary?
And I happen to know that he recorded every single moment of it.
He did.
Yes, he did. It was his bride.
Bride.
Sorry.
That seems to be the answer. I would.
Not really.
Yeah. What do you know? What is the answer?
Oh, it's really his confidence.
His confidence began to self-destruct. That's a good one. Okay. My honeymoon was really an impossible mission. As soon as we got into the hotel room, my blank began to self-destruct.
That's funny. Your honeymoon was the same as Greg's. Wow, what was your answer?
My answer was...
You didn't have one, did you?
No, I didn't.
I'll tell you why your wife began to self-destruct. Death before dishonor. Passion.
Passion.
All right. Nice word for it.
So far, he's looking... no one's offered William Mitchell one body yet. Do you offer...
Well,
Billy?
Listen, Billy.
She's offered it to everybody else. Why not Billy Mitchell?
Come on now, body's
no.
In.
You know, Brett and I kid, because yeah. She is a doll. I've seen her without her clothes, and right on her little bottom says Mattel.
Right. The original no Betsy Wetsy.
Your question coming up, but right now, coming up is this message for you. Here we go, folks.
Okay.
Second half of round one. Ready?
Ready?
This is for you, my dear. Tarzan said.
He said, boy, keep those singing lessons up, Brett.
Tarzan said, me hate April Fool's Day. Last April, Jane put blank on my vine. Jane put blank on my vine.
They were never married. Well, I've said that before.
That's right.
They weren't.
They weren't married.
I'm surprised they show that stuff on television. Where'd they get boy from? They sent away from him. No, it's an A. Put it down.
What is that?
It's the European spelling.
Okay.
And you're selling tuna fish?
Yes. Tarzan said, me hate April Fool's Day. Last April, Jane put blank on my vine.
Greece,
she says.
Greece on my vine.
Greece on my vine.
And a melody
you on
in
my mind.
Heart.
Hello, Greg.
Between her, and you over here, right? I'm going deaf in both ears.
What'd she say? She said grease. Jane put grease on my vine.
Yeah.
Grease it is.
Well, there's one for you.
Yes, he is.
She did it every April Fool's Day. That's why when you saw him swinging from those trees, he went from tree to tree going, because he was calling. Grease on his vine.
So far we got two greasy vines.
Well, although where she got it in the jungle, I'll never know, unless she talked him into combing his hair. I said grease.
Three greasy vines. That's a terrible jungle with all those greasy vines floating around.
It's what such a got? Wonderful thought, though. Slip.
Slip, yep.
I said greasy.
That's four greasy vines.
Four greasy vines. I'm surprised that Gary does not know where Jean gets that from. She gets that from Cheetah. He's a grease monkey. Don't you love mechanical jokes?
Yes, I do. There's
grease.
One. Another one.
Is there
five.
Any other kind?
And you? Six.
Wow.
You know, that rarely happens. That really is most unusual to get all six in the first round. So that means, William, you got your work cut out for you. You got to get them all and achieve a tie. Which one do you want?
I'll try B, please.
All right, everybody plays. Phil said, there's this mailbox near my house. It's almost human. Whenever I put in a letter, it blanks. There's this mailbox near my house. It's almost human.
I finish.
Whenever I put in a letter, it blanks.
Can I just go move my car? Finish.
All right.
Can I?
No, not yet. Just take a second.
Oh, I got it. I got it. Just a minute. I tell you, it just took a few minutes.
All right. Now we'll come over here to Bill Mitchell. All right, Billy. Phil said, there's this mailbox near my house. It's almost human. Whenever I put in a letter, it blanks.
Speaks.
It speaks. All right, he says speaks. Got to match everybody to stay in the game, Greg.
I said snatches it.
It snatches it. So that means Marcia Kaufman wins the game. Okay. Here you go again. Now, got to say goodbye to Billy Mitchell. Thank you. We've got a gift for you. Thank you for being with us, Billy Mitchell.
Come on. Bye-bye.
Message for you, and then you come right back. Gene Rayburn, MatchM75. Goodbye. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 75, a Mark Woodson, Bill Sutman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.